DJ, you mentioned earlier that you've retired for 2 years already. You're very active because you do write, you come out with articles. And we're doing a fast talk segment on you because I know that a lot of our viewers would want to get to know you more. We've compiled some titles from your articles that you've published, and we hope to ask questions anchored on those titles. So I guess let's start with, there was one article you wrote, Things My Father Didn't Teach Me. Give us one example.
Well, not to be corrupt.
Okay, that's what your father taught you.
Yes, not to be corrupt. One,
okay.
Two, do public service with greatest honesty and integrity.
Okay.
Don't make money out of public service.
Don't make money out of public service. Okay, hubris and May 2022. What do you think is going to be the battleground issue for the upcoming elections?
Well, number one, I think, is still economic hardship among our people. There's more poverty, there's more hunger, prices are up. So pandemic is also another issue. And third, of course, is corruption. It is very clear from the Philippine Senate hearing that there is evidence of a possible fraud, and because of the amount involved, plunder.
Okay. Another title, Monetary Policy Should Guard Versus Itself. What is the biggest risk?
The biggest risk, of course, is if the cost push pressures prove to be more prolonged than expected, we will see a more entrenched inflation pressure. Mm. And that will require the BSP to start acting by adjusting the policy rate. The problem there, of course, is we're still in the early stage of economic recovery. So the BSP will find itself in a bind of continuing to support economic recovery, but at the same time, you have some pressures on the inflation front.
DG, do you think the central bank may be overdoing the monetary support?
Well, I do not want to judge the BSP, but I think in the current situation, fiscal policy should do the heavier lifting. Because the problem is that demand, it is basically one that is driven, okay, by economic scare among our people, because of lockdowns, because of restricted social mobility. People cannot go out to buy, to eat out, and even manufacturers and service providers are also prevented from increasing or expanding their capacity. So much as the BSP wants to increase credit, you know, by reducing the policy rate and pumping more liquidity into the system, that will be of no use. It should be fiscal policy that should do the heavier lifting. The government needs to spend and spend wisely.
Spend and spend wisely indeed. Adobo syndrome. What is the adobo syndrome and what's the cure, sir?
No, remember, there was one person who wanted to do a template on how adobo should be prepared. I was saying in that column that perhaps we should focus our attention on somewhere more compelling and more socially important. I mean, we are in the middle of a pandemic, and people are talking about adobo.
No, but we all love adobo.
Oh, yes. That's my favorite favorite food.
DG, okay. And finally, saving and borrowing for the future. What would be your best money advice at this point?
Well, cash is king, number one.
Still?
Yeah. Two, I go for equities, but I stay within the blue chips category. And of course, real estate. I think that would be my biggest advice.
Okay. And before we end, DG, I wanted to get your take on something more futuristic. Well, the future is here. Cryptocurrencies, digital currencies. Why do you think institutions, including government agencies, appear a little bit hostile or deeply skeptical about the cryptocurrencies. And just look at what China's doing, cracking down on all sorts of crypto transactions, deeming them all illegal. And do you think it's time for the Philippine Central Bank to fully and more embrace it, or perhaps explore more seriously a central bank digital currency? And well, I'm not sure if this conversation started during your time.
In fairness to the BSP is now looking into it. Mm-hmm. I think a research team has been established precisely to look into it. Mm-hmm. I think that is one part of the wave of the future crypto assets or cryptocurrency. The problem there, of course, is very few would understand the blockchain technology or the technology that drives crypto assets or cryptocurrency. And because of the relative non-transparency of how pricing, for example, is done, then people are more conscious about this. But if more and more people are going into cryptocurrency, that will have a very important impact on domestic liquidity. How then do we define domestic liquidity? That's one. Two, if more and more people are going into crypto assets or crypto currency, I think the BSP should go into the picture and start doing some so-called sandbox approach. Okay, in other words, what would be the implications on liquidity? To consumer protection is also paramount. Unless there is a third party to these transactions, there is a point in the future when some stalemate in the operation of crypto assets would be reached, and that's going to be to have some impact on the integrity of the transaction itself, and crypto assets will be put in a bad light.
Okay, DG, always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for the insights. Thank you for joining us, sir. Do keep safe. We hope to see you soon and have you more on the show. More.
Thank you very much, Mimi.
Okay.
Keep safe. Keep safe.
Keep safe, sir.